Hi, I'm Michael Correa, and this is Psych Exam Review. In this video, we're going to begin exploring the topic of memory. Now, when we talk about memory, there's three terms that we're going to use repeatedly, and these are encoding, storage, and retrieval. So, encoding refers to when we create a memory, we first sort of input that memory into our mind, and then storage, of course, refers to storing the memory over time, and retrieval refers to accessing the memory. Now, you'll notice that these three terms are all sort of analogous to the terms you would use to talk about a computer storing memory. And this is a useful analogy on some occasions, but it's important to remember that this is a very, very big oversimplification of how the mind works. Your brain is much, much more complicated than even the most advanced of computers. And the way that memory works is not really like a computer. So even though we use these terms, it's not a good idea to think of memories as being stored the way a computer stores memory. Right? And the reason for this is that for us, there's a possibility of error and bias at each of these steps of the memory process. In other words, we can input memories incorrectly, right? And we can have memories change over time. You know, if you store a memory on a computer, you know, the information just stays there, and when you access it later, it's exactly the same. That's not how your mind works. We're going to see that repeatedly in this unit, that when you access a memory, you can actually change it, right? And when you each time you recall a memory and then you sort of re-encode it back into your long-term memory, there's a chance that you've modified it a bit, that there's some bias to it. And so keep in mind that failures are possible at any of these steps. And in this way, it's very different from the way that a computer stores information, right? Because on a computer, assuming you input the information correctly, then it will just store an identical copy of that information, and when you call it up, it'll be exactly the same as it was when you put it in. And your mind doesn't work that way. And we'll see that, as I said, repeatedly. Okay, so one way to think about memory is to divide it up into different types of memory. And so the first model that we're going to start with is called the three-box model. And this is also called the Atkinson-Shiffrin model, because it was first proposed by Richard Atkinson and Richard Shiffrin. So the three-box model divides memory storage up into three main stores. So the first of these stores is the sensory store. And this is very, very brief. This lasts for only about a second. So when information first comes in, it's in this sensory store. And we can pay attention to only a small fraction of that information, right? The information that's available to you at any time is essentially infinite, right? If you just look around the room, all of the things you could pay attention to, it's essentially endless. So some of that you're going to pay attention to. And that means some of it has the possibility of moving to the next stage of the memory process, and this is short-term memory. So the short-term store lasts a little bit longer, but it's still pretty brief. At most, maybe a few minutes, but probably much shorter than that, on the matter of, you know, 30 seconds or perhaps even less. So this is a short-term store that is able to hold some of that information that you first sort of took in, right? Some of that information from the sensory store is going to make it to the short-term store. And then some of that information is going to make it to the long-term memory store. Right? And this is information that we can hold for, again, it could be a few minutes or it could be as long as a lifetime. Right? You could have memories from your childhood that stay with you for your entire life. Now, these memories are still subject to bias and change over time, but we could consider them as being, you know, long-term memories that last for decades. Okay, so we have this process of moving from each of these stores to the next. So there's sort of an encoding process that occurs to move sensory information to the short-term memory, and then another encoding process to move it to long-term storage. And along the way, if we think of these as boxes here, since this is the three-box model, along the way, some information is going to be lost. There's going to be information that's not encoded. And there's going to be things in your short-term memory that you lose. And there's going to be things, as you probably know, you know, when the test day arrives and that memory you thought was in your long-term memory isn't actually there, there's going to be some loss of information at any of these steps. All right. Now, it's important to remember that this is obviously a simplification. I mean, it's a very simple model of how memory works. And there's a lot of things that are missing from this model. And there's things that it doesn't account for, and we'll see that as well. But in general, it's a pretty good way to divide up our memory storage into the sensory store, short-term store, and long-term store. And in the next few videos, we'll take a look at each of these types of storage in a little more detail. Okay, I hope you found this helpful. If so, please like the video and subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.